This is the last place I wanted to drive my truck. I've never seen that power stroke before around town. Duramax made it to the place that I didn't want it to make it, and that is the warehouse. Unfortunately, we are working on the Duramax. This video is actually filmed before the reveal video. The coolant's leaking out of it. I really have to fix it, so that's what we're doing tonight. It's going to be a late one, as you can see. I mean, it's already dark outside. That's not the morning. This is the evening. It looks like I'm going to have to manufacture my own tool to get this one nut off. So, this should get interesting. So now that my new tool is as hot as my sweatshirt, I gotta let this thing cool down. You know you're doing the job right when you need a bigger hammer. As you can see, I'm creating more room for activities. Unfortunately, I'm not a big, huge fan of these activities. I'd rather just drive the truck. I'd rather just put diesel in it, cruise down the road, making a lot of noise and a lot of power. But I'm strange. I don't think a lot of people like that. I think they like working on these things more. I'm not thrilled about it, but I'm sure the Duramax is. So this is bonding time, I guess. This is the next day. I needed a special tool, or I needed to remove the starter off this thing. I tried to remove the starter off this thing. It wasn't having anything of it. So that's when I went downtown to try to find this special part. I figured they wouldn't have it. They didn't have it. So then I went on to Amazon, ordered the part. Then I went up to Kyle S's, and his dad said that he had that part. Went back home to cancel the order because I figured I could use his. You know, that's what friends are for. And then Kyle texted me and says, I don't have that tool. So then I have to go back on Amazon, order it. Then he texts me, oh yeah, I have that tool. So then I had to re-cancel it. Amazon's probably gonna ban 3D machines. That's all there is to it. Don't, why are you bringing this up? Well, I'm bringing this up because we're gonna finally use that tool, and I'll show you what that tool looks like. The tool looks like this, and I guess there's actually two of them, but I'm pretty sure I use this one. There's an inspection plate by the transmission, or I guess on the transmission. I throw this in there, it locks up the entire engine so that I can remove a big, big bolt that is going to need a lot of torque. Now, out of the entire world's population, only a few of them have tools. And out of those ones that have tools, only a few have an extensive tool set. And then on top of that, the people that have an extensive tool set don't have these two tools. Well, a lot of them don't have these two tools. A 36 millimeter 12 point socket and that handy dandy tool that's gonna lock up this entire engine. So I can use this socket on the bolt I'm going to remove that is down here. This is gonna need torque. Didn't even need a cheater bar. Kyle, thank you. You're a lifesaver. That is a bolt. And that's a washer. I turned the camera off because I figured this was going to be a huge pain, because last night we actually worked on Kyle S's same exact problem. He's got a bad water pump because he couldn't get his harmonic balancer off. And last night I spoke to a mechanic, a diesel mechanic, that says, yeah, dude, those things are impossible to take off. I'm like, well, on YouTube, everybody like slides them off with ease. Everybody who has a Duramax just slides them right off with ease. He's like, yeah, right, man, you gotta heat them up. Kyle was having issues. I go to touch mine, it slides right off. Like nothing. I am definitely gonna re-grease this as well. Hallelujah. Here's my old water pump. My new water pump's in my truck. While I'm at it, I'm also changing the power steering box. So we're killing two birds with one stone today. Remember when I was on my way down to Florida and my wheel fell off my truck? Well, something almost as bad as that would have almost happened if I didn't see what I saw. Kyle hooked me up, I can show you. All right, so down in there where I'm shining the light, that's the end of the CV axle. It has 6 bolts that hangs onto that to drive the wheel. You see that nice new shiny bolt? That is a new bolt. Okay, Dalton, but you got 5 others to hang onto the CV axle. No, I do not. It was down to 1 bolt and 1 that I could unscrew by hand. Now, if that CV axle came out, it would have started throwing itself everywhere, and God only knows what would have happened. How I stumbled upon it was I was going to take my starter off so I could take this 1 bolt off to get my harmonic balancer off, which is that big heavy thing that I showed you earlier. And while I was down by the starter, I saw that the CV axle was down to 1.5 bolts. Whew. My one buddy totaled his whole truck with a CV axle accident. I'm glad we didn't total the Duramax. This was really freaking me out. It's only been on for like 30 seconds, but this looked like fluid flying or squirting out. It's actually from my Christmas tree. At this point in the vlog, I want to thank all of you machines for allowing me to be able to be in a shop of my very own in a t-shirt in the middle of winter. I'll clean up my mess tomorrow. Be a machine. I gotta get the out of here.